that look is looking amazing. He's got those ultra banana socks tonight.
Okay.
Every color, help me. Free thinkers. That's all we all are.
Next thing you know, I'll be voting.
This is actually we're a comedy. No. First song is called Lag. Yeah. How do you keep a crowd in suspense? I'll tell you later. Just getting ready. Bottom off for nothing.
But first, we must do calisthenics together. Are you ready?
Pop the little calisthenics. Everyone, arms out.
What a 2-1.
Feeling kind of saucy this evening. Well, anyways, we're this stupid band that comes from Berserkly. Anyway, this first song is called 2,000 Light Years Away. We're Green Day.
I think I changed my mind.
this, well, no, now I'm back in this town called Rodeo in California. But, the song's about how I moved out of my house and the trials and tribulations of a teen. That's not what it's called, but... this song's called Welcome to Paradise.
I'm not a lover, and I'm here to survive. We'll be right back. This song's called Christy Road.
I'm gonna make you mine.
right. Now, we all know that fighting.
Is give peace a chance.
This is a brand new song. This song is called Long View.
The tube, but no one's calling. I change the channels for an hour or two. I tweet all my thumbs just for a bit. I'm sick of all the same old shit. In the house with the locked doors, and I'm fucking crazy. This Velcro seat, get me moving. I sure as hell can't do it by myself. I'm feeling like a dog in heat. Fart indoors on the summer streets. It fills the doors of my own cell, and I lost the key. Be pathetic, call me what you will. My mother says to get a job, but she don't like the one she's got. When masturbation's lost its fun, you're fucking low. Hey, Ben, go get the number.
Only users use drugs, man.
Users are losers. Losers are losers.
What? Is Gregor in the house? Are you Gregor, really? This is a very important phone call for you, if you are. It's a very important phone call. Gregor, you should go. Right out front.
Here we go. I'm
to say happy birthday to Robin. It's her birthday. That's why you're all here.
Usually we wouldn't play a 21 and over club, but it's Robin's birthday, so it's a special occasion.
Even though we're not the best kissers in the world, we give the best head in the world.
Thank you. Oi, oi, oi.
Too. It is her birthday. She's much older now.
She's 70 years old.
And you know how I like older women. This is for you, Robin. That was so genius. I was thinking of you. Oh yeah, did I mention I was all by myself? All by myself. I was all by myself. All by myself. Went to your house.
Yeah.
suffering from his freezing fucking hurt down something the other day, yeah. And the story goes on.
Nobody ever told me, I found out for myself. You gotta believe in foolish miracles. It's not how you play the game, it's if you win or lose, you can't choose.
She likes us, and we liked her, and
Hi, interviewing for
Hi. Hello. How you doing? My name is Mike Pritchard. I'm 20 years old.
His name is Mike Dirt. D-I-R-N-T.
Can you give you guys
your
age?
No, he's 19. Herman's 19. So, we're illegal right now.
Yeah, don't tell anyone that.
Otherwise, we'll drink you up.
How many of you guys are founding members?
Founding members? I don't know, do you want to like take the claim to this or not? No, man. Me and him have been playing since we were like, well, me and Mike. We've been playing together since we were,
It seems like, you know.
Like 10?
Yeah, 10 or 11.
And we just always jammed together. And I don't know, we went through our shitty heavy metal cover stage and every other stage.
We're like best friends, so it just kind of,
yeah,
to
it's
do.
Not even really. It's not even really
a
like.
Band, it's never been a band thing. It's always been like, hey, let's jam.
Yeah. And it was, I'll show him things. He'll show me things.
I heard you've been like playing guitar forever.
I've been
singing forever.
I've been singing.
Before he could walk.
I've been singing since I was five.
Really?
A record out called Look for Love.
Man.
Erase that.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I guess maybe like, I guess now I'd probably, if you're five and I'm 20 now, then that means most people would probably be lounge singers instead of like playing and
we'd be the Ramones.
The Ramones? Yeah, well, I guess.
So did you like grow up in a musical family or something?
My dad was a jazz drummer and my mom was, I mean, I don't know. I mean, just all, they always had instruments lying around. So, I mean, there's like six kids all together and we all just kind of picked up things.
Kind of like the Osmonds.
Yeah, I mean, they're like Partridge Family. That's where we get our sound in.
I saw in the insert of one of your albums, you guys like got a letter from some major label.
Do I have to comment on that?
Yes.
Too bad. No, it's not.
That's sort of that's totally against the mindset. Yeah. So, you know, that's sort of foreign to everybody's going to be reading the magazine.
Yeah, I don't know. It's really,
our old drummer had a lot to do with that.
Yeah,
let's just
put
it that way.
I don't know. I mean, I don't want to be like, that sounds like, you know, prove your punk rockness, you know, and our old drummer, he pretty much put that in there.
And then we found out when we got the record.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah, and so we never really.
What'd you guys have that?
What's that?
What'd you guys
at the time, you know, it's like, well, it was like, at the time it was like, well, you know, we're punks, this is what we're doing. It's kind of different now, you know, it's like, we just see different areas of music and we've been playing so long now. I mean, so much more, it's just kind of weird, you know. It's like, geez, there's a lot more than just, you know, clubs out there and stuff.
Yeah, it's weird because it's like, I don't know, at that time we were like, in like total, like we're the only like band of our kind in our scene, like it was so soft and melodic and stuff, and I don't know,
and they finally accepted us.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, it's not even that. I mean, I
seems like you guys
I have nothing, we're just a band, we don't have anything to prove to anybody, you know. We're just,
that's good. So are you guys a punk rock band?
Well, yeah, I wouldn't ever, like, I would never, you know, disclaim ourselves from where we come from, because that's where we come from, and that's like totally, like, punk rock is like the foundation of like what music is today, you know. Every single band, you know, if there was no Ramones, there would be nothing, you know.
There would be no Green Day.
Well, yeah, of course, but I mean, just like everything, but everything you listen to on the radio, you know, it's like the Chili Peppers and like, and Nirvana, and you know, and I like those bands, don't get me wrong, but you know, the Ramones, gotta hand it to the guys. They knew what was up.
Listening to you guys' records, you guys have a sound that really seems like it should be popular. Is there any reason why you're
on the smallest label you've ever heard of?
Well, it's...
What label are you on?
Lookout?
Lookout? Okay, I don't know.
Well, I don't know. It's weird. A lot of bands use, like, I guess the punk scene or whatever, to
that's
use
like
as a
stepping
stone to get where they want, you know. And
it's,
I don't know, we kind of wanted to root ourselves in with that, since that's where we, you know, are base ourselves from. So
it wasn't like we started off going, okay, we're gonna make a demo and send it out, or make a 7-inch and send it out. It's kind of like, geez, you know, make another record, sure, you know, do this, and it just progressed.
Yeah, and everything that, we've never went out and got anything. Everything's kind of come to us. All we did was just, like, keep practicing, keep playing Gilman Street, and, like, pretty soon people, you know, started coming and, you know.
Like, actually, you can run.
Yeah, well, they're told, you know, there's no contracts,
like family,
there's no bullshit, you know. It's, yeah, I mean,
it does.
You know, Trey lived on a mountain with Lawrence Livermore.
What?
Yeah. So, you know, we totally trust them. It's handshakes and hugs and stuff, you know. It's no contracts or anything like that.
So, that's cool. So you can probably stay with Lookout.
Definitely. I don't know. I'm not going to comment on that because you never know what happens. Right? You know, it's like we have, everybody has their sort of these ideals that they have when they're 17, and you notice, like, as years go by, when you're like 21, 22, they're almost, I mean, they're just kind of the same thing, but it's still, you know, there's still a lot of change.
You're a different person than you were.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You know.
You see obstacles in your growing path, you know. It's kind
of... So what kind of music did you guys listen to when you first started out?
Or what Van Halen. Things like that. Like the Replacements. You know,
I like the Replacements. And, I don't know. I really like Nirvana. I mean, those guys kind of, the people call them sellouts and stuff, but I mean, face it, you know, it's like, they cheated, you know, it's like, you're supposed to come out with a shitty record when you sell out. You're saying they came out with that, like, the greatest one in years, you know.
Can't still sort of getting in a fight with Axl Rose.
Yeah, well, you know.
Axl Rose. I don't know, man. He's immature. He's a Hesher.
Yeah. I don't know. It's funny because, like, I don't know, Kurt Cobain said something about, like, oh, it's, you know, not happened to me since, like, the sixth grade or something.
It's totally funny because, you know, fighting is just ridiculous anyway, you know.
Yeah.
It just seems like that's a more alternative view instead of like a one-track mind that I can see coming from the other direction.
You guys, your last record was out like what, a year ago?
What, The Plug?
No,
it came out in February.
Oh, really? Something bad. We're working on doing that, or?
We don't want to write songs for an album. I'd rather just write songs, and then we'd have like a shitload of songs, so we'd be able to like choose like whatever.
You get about 15 of them.
What's that?
You get about 15 of them.
Yeah, or whatever. You know, I know sometimes we write songs at a weird pace. You know, for a long time we won't write any songs, and then all of a sudden we'll like write in a week we'll write like six or seven. We'll go, whoa, shit,
that happened.
So the whole band get together.
Bill will write most of the songs, and then we'll get together, and all the ideas will flow. Because me and Bill playing together so long kind of connects a little bit. And then me and Trey, it took me like 7 months to get used to playing with Trey because he's so good, you know.
Yeah.
I had to get better myself. I was like, I don't know.
He's not the first drummer we had, right?
Yeah. We had the old drummer play my soccer scene. John Kiffmeyer.
John Kiffmeyer. But, I don't know, he went off to college. We're still friends. He went off to college and, you know, trade.
So you guys, are you pretty much like thriving in your music, or do you have like jobs and stuff?
Nah, we don't have jobs.
No. Yeah, we're not rich, but we don't have jobs.
Yeah, we don't have like some high standard of living or anything. It also helps to live with your mom, so.
Well, that helps.
Yeah. So, I mean, yeah.
That's where it's at.
Yeah, you know. So, I mean, you know, we don't have any big, we're not.
So it just covers the bills, and then we just keep playing and enjoy ourselves.
Good to see you guys keep on going like this forever.
Well, shit, man, I wouldn't mind fucking 10 years from now writing the shittiest songs ever, but still being together, you know? That's what it's all about. Yeah. Staying together and writing songs.
Yeah, staying together writing shitty songs.
Staying together writing shitty songs.
What do you think of Seattle?
I like it. The Space Needle's really pretty at night.
I don't know, I'd like to have like a tour of Seattle, but we're never here long enough to actually.
We're almost here for like a day or two.
Not even 2 days.
Yeah,
we're like here for like
a day in the morning.
Yeah, we'll come at night, play the show. Next morning.
Tomorrow morning, we're going to,
Vancouver. We're playing in Vancouver tomorrow.
You guys on a tour? Like,
yeah. Oh yeah, just like a 2 week sort of thing.
Yeah, we booked it around the show. We played in Kennewick last night. Some guys had this huge show. Like,
yeah, this guy
750 people or something.
Yeah, I want to fucking pass this on. And this guy is from Misophobic Records.
Oh yeah, Guy.
Guy, yeah. He's amazing. The guy puts on fucking shows.
We headlined a show for 750 people.
Yeah.
We've never played there before.
So they all like from Portland.
Yeah, we're playing in Kennewick.
There's a few of them.
On Halloween.
Oh, really? What band are you playing with?
1007. On an even smaller label than yours. Yeah. Even less known than you are. Yeah, he does great stuff. I mean, that's the biggest crowds we've played are in Kennewick.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's fucking... He knows just how to get people at shows, you know? He put out like...
That's more people than came to your last show.
Yeah, he put out like 2,500 flyers, you know, and he just...
They were everywhere. You go to McDonald's, you go to the bathroom, you're like taking a piss in the stall, and you look up and there's one right in front of you or something,
yeah.
You know? Just amazing amounts.
That's the way to do that. So who's the coolest band in the Bay Area right now?
Operation Ivy.
Everybody's breaking up. At least all the punk bands are, I mean, let's see.
I still wrote the first answer.
Yeah.
Operation Ivy.
Jawbreakers
are all
good,
breaking up. Operation Ivy would have to be it.
Mr. T just broke up. Jawbreakers. I heard that they're gonna break up.
Sam I Am's doing real good.
Fun. Are Jawbreakers gonna break up?
I think so, because, what do you call it, Blake Singer, he's got a cyst in his throat. So, and he, like, I guess, I don't know, it's, like, fatal for his voice, you know. Not fatal, like, he's gonna die, but it's, like, he's gonna, his voice is just gonna... So they're like playing, they're in Europe right now, and they had to cut down their sets really low, and I don't know, it does suck because they're a great band.
Yeah, I saw them here last time they came, the guys sounded like me. So who's the coolest band in Seattle?
I don't know.
Let me guess.
Okay. It's sick and wrong.
You see, sounds like, smells like.
Smells like
sick and wrong.
Who?
Sick and wrong?
No. I just had to ask that. Yeah. There's guys that came out from the Lollapalooza tour.
Oh yeah, that was North American Bison and the Daves.
Yeah, now that was that Daves.
The Daves and North American Bison. And
now those guys. Now that's what touring is all about.
Yeah, at the end of their tour, their last show, before they got to their last show, their brakes cut out on the freeway. They went off on an off ramp that was about a semicircle, and they kept going straight in an RV. There was like five of them, the roof was off, and one of them broke his arm, but like the driver got, I mean, luckily they're all alive, you know? And the Daves couldn't play because the drummer was just messed up real bad, but North American Bison came to the show, and they played the show anyway, and you know, of course we just said, hey, take the money, you know, whatever.
Yeah, we just said, we gave them all our money, and they were like,
oh, I didn't hear about that.
Yeah, it, man, I just...
What label makes it this bad?
Yeah. What's that?
They're on the same label.
Oh, right? Really?
Yeah,
man,
I just... Fuck, man. Really?
Yeah.
Weird.
Have their tapes.
I don't know. That's,
have their tapes.
That's like a scare. That's like a tour nightmare coming true. You know, it's like
they're supposed to be coming out.
Any, like the worst thing possible you could imagine happening to. Except that's, everybody stayed alive.
That's what we're playing with on Halloween.
No, we've been in a couple accidents, but never anything. Actually, we got through an accident in Seattle.
Yeah, someone hit us from behind.
Yeah, it's weird driving.
Woke me up.
I saw it coming too, because I was like sitting outside in the loft, or looking, well not outside, but I was on the loft, and I was looking out the window, and I was like, here it comes, like this guy, I see this guy, fucking this kid, boom, it was like a 3-car collision.
I remember waking up going, what an asshole.
Yeah, that's exactly what he said, but he said, he's all, what an asshole.
Was that the time you were supposed to play in Seattle, like about 2 years ago?
Well, we played in Bremerton.
Washington, because we're actually supposed to open for you like a long time ago, and you guys weren't able to make it.
The party hall?
Yeah, the party hall. Paula was doing the show.
Yeah.
It was a long time ago.
I don't know. I remember talking to Paula about a party or something of some sort, but then we went to Bremerton and made a party out there, so maybe that was the mix up there.
You guys tour a lot
now? And we try to,
yeah,
but we've been staying home.
Yeah, we've been at home for a little while, but compared to the other bands around from where we like tour constantly.
Like 7 months a year or something.
Yeah.
Never like gone overseas and shit?
Yeah, we went to Europe. We did 3 months in Europe.
64 shows.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, it was awesome. Totally came back. We're totally exhausted.
Just came back, kissed the ground we walked on. But we really loved it out there, too.
How do you go about getting shows in Europe?
I don't know. Yeah. If we get a phone call and they say, you want to book a tour for you guys in Europe? We say, yeah, sure.
Yeah.
It sucks because, like, European bands can't... The United States really sucks for touring. Because, you know, it's really...
They can't come out here. They won't make enough. You know, they won't make shit.
Yeah.
And like, L.A.
And nobody gives,
like,
and nobody gives a shit,
you
know? It sucks that, you know, I'm a fan from Germany, you know. Whatever, you know.
Yeah.
And out there, you go to the show, they pay you tons of money, they give you tons
and
of beer, they feed
shows
you.
Up,
you know.
Anybody who's an American.
It's there's also the people who are kind of offended by it too, because bands, they won't even tour in like the United States, they'll just go straight out to Europe and then
it's like overbearing,
kind of,
you know?
And it kind of sucks because, you know, we see some bands out there that are just like, you know, what the fuck, you know? I mean, it's just... I don't know, it's just kind of like...
It's like using the scene out there. They get out there and they go, dude, like, where's our hotel and our guarantee and blah, blah, blah. And like, oh, no, okay, number one, you're playing a squat, you know?
Yeah.
Number two, the people that booked your tour are as full of shit as you are, you know? I mean, this shit's really bad, you know? You'll play shows out there, lots of shows in a row, where it'll be all American bands. And that's horrible, you know?
Yeah.
German bands are, or not even German, but any European man can't even get a gig with you, you know?
Pretty fucked up. Is that pretty much their fault? I mean,
I guess you could say it is because they book the shows and everything, and they like to book American bands, but you could also say it's part of, like, there's like, different people from the, I mean, there's, like, different people in from every country out there booking shows for American bands out here, and they need to step off a little bit, I think, you know.
Look who we have here. This is Trey Cool.
Hey.
What's up? I'm Trey Cool, 19.
Wow, even younger.
We're just a bunch of young lads. So, like, who are you guys?
Ages.
I'm Rob.
Age.
23.
Old fucker.
Yeah, guess my age.
I'm 23.
Hey, wrong.
What?
Hey. Try to guess.
21.
Wrong.
19.
Wrong.
20?
Wrong.
17.
21.
22.
22.
man, we're failing.
Yeah, I'm sure there are good bands in Europe, but I don't know. I
thought
it
was
like
name. We can name some. There's the No Twist, excellent band from Germany.
Doctor and the Crippens,
they're really good. There's Lightfoot How to Live It, from where are they from? Norway? Or something?
Yeah. So much hate.
So much hate. Fucking
rocks, you know.
You like see them from over there?
They have better English lyrics than I've heard of any American bands out here spill out. You know.
Do they get records over here and stuff?
Very, very little. The distribution out here.
I've seen them in Berkeley too.
Yeah, but that's...
You gotta look around for them.
You couldn't get them in just like fucking
Tom's music store or even like Tom's punk music store. You know, you'd have to go to like Punk Surplus Outlet. You know.
You know, go through Blacklist or something. You know. Yeah, there aren't very many stores around here that have their own stuff. Yes. I'll remember what I said.
Okay.
I guess that's just pretty much about it. Is there anything you want to add?
Well, since I have no idea what you already talked about, no.
Well, just make up something.
Yeah. Okay, I'll tell you about the time that I stabbed my uncle's dog.
Yeah, there you go.
That's a great story.
That's a great story. Go ahead, tell us the story.
Well, I was riding up my uncle's driveway, and Buck, my uncle's favorite hunting dog, ran up and bit my leg real hard. It hurt real bad. And he didn't let go, so I stabbed him, and he took 2 weeks to die.
That's a true story.
He didn't wake up, but he didn't die for 2 weeks. He just laid there by the fire, and when I came over to play with my cousins, it was like an intense reminder that I had stabbed my uncle's only dog.
He was asking for it, yeah.
But
you did what you had to.
Yeah, you know, too many dogs around anyway. Any more cats?
No, I would never stab a dog again.
What you were gonna say?
And that's all I have to say.
Which character in Star Wars do you most relate to?
R2-D2.
I'm kind of full of shit, you know?
Who would you?
R2-D2?
R2-D2. Because you resemble Yoda.
Stay short.
Yeah, maybe Yoda. Because there's a bunch of people.
Billy, you Luke Skywalker, shut up.
There's our friend Lucky Dog that was, he was Han Solo. And there's this girl Monica that was Princess Leia. And I just said, look, I gotta get on this. I'm Yoda. And they said, okay.
That's cool.
So I'm Yoda.
All right, one last thing. Next time we come out to Seattle.
Marmoset!
No. Next time we come out to Seattle, someone try and like hook us up a tour, man, and let us see this place.
Next time we wanted someone to drag our asses around all day.
We want a detailed map of all the thrift stores in the area. And we want somebody willing to give up a few hours to make sure we get there. And if that doesn't happen, they'll never come back.
And the marmosets will come to
thrift stores.
This store, man, right here.
Okay. You kidding,
Sharks
man?
Clothing, Telegraph Avenue, Berkeley.
You got
smashed. Yeah, well, my pants, I got my pants at Kmart, but I paid to myself. And I got
Dead
my
uncle.
Shoes.
Dead I got uncle. This in the pre-box at People's Park.
Really?
My shoes, I got these from...
Wow. Okay, they gave me one, too. Cool. They just stamped it on.
Now you guys
smoking cigarettes is bad for you. Don't do it.
No, we don't really have a symbol. Green Day, that's the symbol.
Zildjian.
Symbol of youth in America, man. What it's like to be fucking young again, man.
Live fast, die young.
Ludwig rocks. Drum set.
Trey Cool
Zildjian exclusive symbols.
When are you coming back? Seattle.
As soon as we get that map.
As soon as we get that map, we'll be back, man. Map around here, the tour.
Otherwise, ain't no use
for
guy. We'll
take you around.
Okay.
All right. Oh, well, let me get your address.
I can probably We should show you the east side if you want to see something weird.
My address is 926 Sand Point Drive, Rodeo, California, 94572.
Drop by anytime.
I thought you lived in Oakland.
Oh, no, I used to live in Oakland, but I moved back here with my mom. These guys live in Brooklyn.
Yeah, we live in Brooklyn. That's cool.
You have any
hey, guys, I got some for
yes,
I got this PO box. Drop in anytime.
Thanks a lot.
All right, guys.
All right, what's the...
926?
926.
Sand Point Drive?
Right.
Sand Point. Let's see, is that point?
So is it okay if I put words in your mouth?
Can I do this?
Wise words.
Rodeo, okay. As in rodeo.
Rodeo Drive.
California. No, California.
Well, semi-wise.
But not rodeo.
But nothing incredibly stupid.
Okay. You'll just plug my band a few times. That's all.
Like in the background, like Satan.
Exactly.
What's that?
What band was? What band is yours?
I used to be in Hand Job. 9 4 5 7 2 Shaft.
Okay, hand job and shaft.
Did you see the Lollapalooza this year?
Yes.
I see that Jim Rose thing.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
The guy who lifts things with his penis is in my band.
Oh, with his tits? The guy, oh really?
I've got one of his rings on my guitar, one of his penis rings. Are you guys sticking around for
a
couple? Oh yeah, do you drink? Yeah. Do you drink?
I'm Edge.
That's hot.
But thanks a lot, you guys.
Hey, thank you.
And we'll see you guys in Keyland.
That's right.
See about that man.
Okay, man.